The Daytona 500 on Fox is brought to you by Ford, the official truck of NASCAR. 41 laps complete. Tony Stewart leads Bill Elliott, Dale Earnhardt Jr., Michael Waltrip, Todd Bodine up to fifth after pit stops, Mark Martin and Mike Wallace. On pits, trouble.
Trouble on the
track. Four, a car spins to the infield. Bobby Labonte.
Caution is on the speedway.
Champ, and that'll put us under caution the first time today.
Well, he did a great job, though. You see that paved area back there, folks. That saved him from tearing his race car all to pieces.
Talk about saving. That saved Jeff Burton from going a lap down because he was just in front of the leaders, losing almost 2 seconds a lap.
One guy's bad luck, another guy's good luck.
And what you see on top of Bobby Labonte's car, that's one of the roof flaps. It has two roof flaps that deploy to help keep the car on the ground when he spins out, something Jack Roush helped develop along with NASCAR.
Jeff Burton, Jeff Green, Casey Mears, all help from going a lap down to the race leaders. Let's see what happened to the green car, Bobby Labonte.
Just coming off that corner, and what happened to him is a 48 goes by on the outside. He's got another car stuffed right up behind him. He must have been a little too loose, just sucked him around.
So no contact there.
No contact.
Just the movement of the air.
Come up off of turn two over there. The car's nice and free, loose. That car right up behind him. He's trying to stay low because Jimmy Johnson's going by on the outside. Around she goes, but I love that paved area back there. Saved his life. See, that thing just kind of, it just slowly, you feel it going as a driver. There's nothing you can do.
Now, what I'm going to anticipate, it's been about 12 laps since some of the first leaders came onto pit road. We may see several of these guys hit pit road for fuel only because, remember, 12 laps is a third of a stop now with the smaller fuel cells.